Hi, it's Corrine for Wild Orchid Crafts and Knitwick Collections, and today I'm here to share a finished Christmas album. I'm using a new paper pack from Knitwick Collections called Fireside Christmas, and this is a gorgeous collection. Knitwick Collections also has quite a few Christmas collections to choose from, so at some point I'm excited to work my way through all of the collections, but this is their newest one, so I'll place a link down in the description box along with all the products used from Wild Orchid Crafts. I used lots of gorgeous Wild Orchid Craft products. Knitwick Collections has a YouTube channel, so check that out. There will be a link for that. When they come out with a new collection, they do a video showing everything that you get in each collection. Today I'm using the bundled collection where you will save 20% when you use that, but you get all of the papers included, none of them duplicates, and you get all of the elements in the collection. So this present that you see here is one of the elements in the collection. As soon as I was watching their video and saw this present, I knew that I needed to make a mini album using this present. So this is a print and cut. This album is approximately 7.5 by 5.5, and I did the same for both the front and back cover. The back I left just one layer. I didn't make this dimensional being that this was the back of the album. And I just want to point out, look at the shadows that Mary Fran puts in all her designs. You can see the shadow here below, the tag for the flower, the ribbon, just absolutely gorgeous. For my spine, I use some of the pattern paper, as well as this here is the pattern paper. And then this is one of the labels in the collection that I just made larger so it fit on the spine. I used some trim that I had in my stash along with this gorgeous flatback pearl from Wild Orchid Crafts. I did add Mod Podge to the entire outside of the album just to help seal it, to protect it. For the front, I did want this dimensional, so I just print and cut out this poinsettia flower with the leaves, and I cut out a second one as well. I popped it up on some foam dimensionals. I added my own label that I had here. It says to and from Santa Claus. I thought it went well, and again I added some foam squares behind that to keep it dimensional. So hopefully you can see the dimension on that. I love how it gave such character to the front of the album cover. For the inside, I have 6 pages. I use Kathy Orta's Hidden Hinge system. For the front page, being that this is the shape of the present, I decided to make the front and back page a scene. So this here is a clustered element that comes in their collection. They give you both separate pieces, so you'll get a separate chair, the presents, the tree, the wreath, this little coal bucket over here, or they do clustered elements as well. So if you don't have the time, or you don't want to spend the time on clustering things yourself, it makes it super easy. You can just print and cut these out. And check out the description box for a video where I go into more detail of how you can use digital paper packs if you've never used them. I added a label here with a foam square underneath, so it gives it a little dimension to go over my wreath. I added these gorgeous snowflakes from Wild Orchid Crafts. These went so well with the collection. And look at the tree. Look at all the detail in the tree. I love that. For my first page here, I used the presents that come in the collection. I did back them on white cardstock to make them a little bit more sturdy, and I made them into a pocket. I added a bow with a sparkling rhinestone from Wild Orchid Crafts. And then I have a couple journaling cards. This one I did back on some black cardstock. It says, "May your days be merry and bright." These are perfect to add journaling to, photos on the back, or both. So photos can be tucked in here as well. And each page has a large pull-out mat that I designed a bracket style edge, cut that out in my Cameo. And this is 6¾ by 5¼. So you can get large photos on this cardstock or add journaling or both. I won't pull them all out, but they're all the same. I love the pop of red against the black on each of these. And I just had it pop out slightly. this next page here, this is just a plain paper, and they come with lots of elements that, like I said, you can cut out separately or you don't have to. So this one here is a great example. I added a cluster that comes in the collection on this bottom left-hand corner and or bottom right, excuse me, and top left corner, and a digital stamp that says, "May the spirit of Christmas fill your heart and your home." So I added those onto the paper and then printed them out. You can also cut these out separately if you wanted to, but I like to be able to customize my own paper. I cut out a couple scallops dies that I had, a label that says Christmas at Home. I did back this on cardstock to make it a little bit more sturdy. And I have a gorgeous cluster here from Wild Orchid Crafts. I used the white poinsettia flowers along with the berry spray in the center. I have some red berries tucked in, some leaves, and some gold leaves as well. I also have this wood word that says joy. And for this die, I have, let me pull it out here real quick. I have a template for whoever uses this album. They can set this template on their photo, cut it out, and it'll be a perfect mat. It'll leave a little mat, so you'll still be able to see the decorative paper with the photo on there. It's not very pretty to look at, so I just tuck it in a pocket. So for this side, I have a mat here that's a perfect mat for a 2x2 photo. I have one of the frames from Wild Orchid Crafts, and I added one of the sayings in the paper collection. I love how that turned out. Again, as I explained, I did add this cluster of flower to the bottom right. I also added an Allie Edwards stamp that says Merry Everything. I cut out a separate flower cluster here and added that along with a heart that comes in the collection. I added some more of those snowflakes from Wild Orchid Crafts, some open roses, and some rose leaves. Really happy with how that turned out. And that frame is left open so the photo can slide right under it. On this side, here is that same Christmas tree. I made it a little bit larger. And also, look at that shadowing in the Christmas tree as well. The details are awesome. See, I don't know if you can see that shadow right there on the fireplace mantle or fireplace. So gorgeous. So the tree, I did back on some cardstock to make it sturdy. I made it a little bit larger for the size that I wanted to coordinate with my page. I added a flower cluster in paper and then also in the mulberry paper from Wild Orchid Crafts. I added a bead to the center. Here is my photo mat and journaling card. I did back this on some black cardstock. A photo can slide under here as well. And then I just turned that tree into a pocket, basically. On this side, I have a scallop pocket. Here is a wreath that comes in the elements. I added that to the paper and then printed it out. I also printed out this label, added some cardstock to the back of it to make it dimensional. And then I have this gorgeous paper in the background here. I have another label, and this is a great example. Here is that same label or same sentiment, but as you can see, I sized it way down to fit into my frame. But here I wanted it as a photo mat or a journaling card, so I sized it up accordingly. So that's just one of the many reasons I love digital collections or working with digital. You can customize them for whatever project you're using. Here's a little card that I had in my stash. It says the most famous reindeer of all. I thought this was adorable. And then here is a tag that comes in the collection. I just simply print and cut this out, added some of the Wild Orchid Craft poinsettia flowers along with a silver sparkle in the center. On this side, I have a bracket edged pocket with a bow and a red enamel dot. Look at this that comes in the collection. It's a window scene. I absolutely love this. This is perfect to add a photo or journaling on the back. But I just think this is so gorgeous, so unique. Here's Home for the Holidays, backed it on some black cardstock, great for a photo. Two journaling cards in two different colors with two different images on them, both gorgeous. And then here's another tag that I added some seam binding to and three of the little miniature jingle bells from Wild Orchid Crafts. This adds such character to the album. On this side, I printed out some of the gorgeous paper, added a digital stamp to it. It says Home for Christmas. And here is that coal bucket. I made it a little bit larger, backed it on some cardstock so I could use it as a stopper for my labels. I added some of the gorgeous paper, backed it on some cardstock. And then look at this as well. I love this. So gorgeous. On this side, I have some paper in the background. I have some matting here. I cut out a deckled edge frame that I have and this ornate oval frame. You probably can't see it, but it's dimensional. There's about four or five layers on this, so it stands up quite a bit. And then I have my cluster over here with the leaves, the snowflakes, the berry spray. And this too also has a template to add a photo to that fits perfectly on this oval. Right here I used the paper collection and just sized it down to fit on this oval. Let me just tuck these back in the pockets. On this side I have a photo mat. It does have some chipboard behind it, so it is dimensional. I have another one of the gorgeous white poinsettia flowers with the berry. And then this paper was plain. I added this border that comes in the collection of all the presents and then printed it out. I added an Allie Edwards stamp that says a little gift for you. On this side, I have another bracket border pocket with a bow, a green enamel dot. And on this paper here, this is from the paper collection. However, these ornaments are separate. I added them before printing them out. And as you can see, they're the same ornaments on this side. So I love that I can use them to customize my paper, but I also use them as die cuts. I enlarge them. This ornament here in the middle, I added three layers to, so it is dimensional. These two are straight down on the paper and they are left open so a photo can slide right underneath. I added some baker's twine to them. And here is my mat. This is, I believe, a 6x4¼, so you can get quite a large photo on front and back of this. Used some more of the flowers with the trim in the center, the bead in the center. And look at this label card. The joy of Christmas is the warmth that enfolds our hearts and our homes. Again, great to add a photo. And then this fun paint chip that is always in their collections. It says, all hearts come home for Christmas. These are some of my favorite just for decoration, but they do make great little journaling spots for names, dates, or like I said, just for decoration. On this last page here, this page was plain. I added the garland border flower trim to it before printing it out, along with one of my own stamps that says Merry Christmas. I added some of this box plated trim from Wild Orchid Crafts, and this garland type trim I got from the dollar store years and years ago, so I was really excited to use some of that up. And that's what I added like to the center of these. I just trimmed a piece off and added that to the center. I love how all the labels, the journaling spots, everything coordinates so well. You don't have to put too much thought into that at all. So here's from the paper collection, backed it on some black cardstock. Another one of these tags. I had an extra one, so I just tucked that in there. And then here is another tag with some pink seam binding from Wild Orchid Crafts and some more of the tiny miniature jingle bells. Here is the last page, my scene. It's the fireplace. You get a couple of fireplaces to choose from. I added some of the stockings that I did make dimensional, so you may not be able to see them there, but they're a little bit dimensional. I added a label here that says Christmas Memories, the little candles, and this garland, I did three layers of it so I could bend up some of the garland just to give it dimension. So I hope you've enjoyed this album. If you'd like, stay tuned for the process of this, and please stop by both Wild Orchid Crafts and Knitwick Collections for all their amazing products. Thanks so much for watching. Thank you.
Hail the heaven-born prince of